This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to calculate the two variable manufacturing overhead variances. And we'll start by talking about the flexible budget and then continue that discussion by clarifying that we're going to be using the flexible budget to calculate those two variances. So with the flexible budget, recall from a previous video that the flexible budget is calculated by taking the standard cost per unit. So for this example, it would be the standard cost per unit for variable manufacturing overhead, and multiply that times the actual units produced. So remember that the flexible budget is prepared after the year has gone by. The master budget is prepared before we start the year, but the flexible budget is after the fact. And so we take the standard cost per unit that we established prior to beginning the year and multiply that times the actual units produced that we know once the year has gone by. So that gives us the flexible budget. And the idea then in the second bullet point here is to compare the flexible budget with the actual costs that we incurred. That is, in this example, the actual variable manufacturing overhead costs incurred, and then try to figure out why we had a difference. And we have two different variances to help us to determine why we had a difference between the flexible budget and actual costs. The first is the variable overhead spending variance, and the second is the variable overhead efficiency variance. And so we'll talk about both of those next. The variable overhead spending variance is the difference between the actual costs for variable overhead and the budgeted costs based on the standards. And so it's calculated here at the very bottom of this slide. It's calculated by taking our actual costs and subtracting from that the budgeted cost based on standard. We figure that out by taking, in this example, we're going to use direct labor hours to allocate variable overhead. Very common for companies to do that. So we're going to take direct labor hours. We would just take the actual direct labor hours times the standard variable overhead rate per direct labor hour. So we're going to take the actual costs minus the actual hours times the standard rate per hour. Next, we'll look at the variable overhead efficiency variance. And the variable overhead efficiency variance is really the difference between the activity level in the allocation base, and again, we're in this series of slides going to use direct labor hours as our activity or allocation base, so we're going to allocate overhead, variable overhead costs based on direct labor hours, and there are many different ways to do it. So just in this example, we just happen to be using direct labor hours because that tends to be pretty common. We could use machine hours or some other form, but we're going to use direct labor hours. So the efficiency variance is really just the measuring the efficiency related to whatever the allocation base is. And if we're using direct labor hours, we're really measuring the difference between the actual activity level in the allocation base and the budgeted activity level in the allocation base. So what were our actual direct labor hours and what were our budgeted direct labor hours? And we'll then attach a cost to each of those related to variable overhead and look at the difference. So at the very bottom here, this is how we calculate the variable overhead efficiency variance. We take the actual hours, here it's direct labor hours, times the standard rate per hour. And that standard rate is not the direct labor rate, it's the standard variable manufacturing overhead rate per direct labor hour. And then we subtract from that the standard number of hours given actual output, more on that later, times the, again, the same standard rate per direct labor hour, standard variable manufacturing overhead rate per direct labor hour. So we take the difference between the two of those, and that gives us the variable overhead efficiency variance. So here's an example of the calculations that are involved with those two variances that we just talked about related to variable manufacturing overhead. And by the way, variable manufacturing overhead, we're not talking about fixed overhead here, we're talking about variable manufacturing overhead. That's a separate lecture that I've created that relates to fixed manufacturing overhead variances. So the two variances that you see here from left to right are the variable overhead spending variance and the variable overhead efficiency variance. So going from left to right, we have actual variable overhead costs of $100,000. So we'll put that there, upper left. And then we have to figure out in the middle column the actual hours. Here they happen to be direct labor hours, so you'll notice that this is the exact same number as the previous lecture that I created for direct labor hour variance analysis. We're going to take actual direct labor hours of 18,900 and multiply it by the standard rate of $5 per hour. And again, that's the standard rate that's related to variable manufacturing overhead, not related to direct labor costs. That's a common confusion that students often have. So the $5 per hour is the variable overhead cost per direct labor hour. And that then totals up to $94,500. And we take the difference between that and our actual costs, and that yields a $5,500 unfavorable variable overhead spending variance. So we essentially spent more than we expected to spend here, given the actual number of direct labor hours worked. Now we go to the far right, and we're looking at the efficiency variance. And you'll notice that we calculate that by taking the standard hours allowed given actual production and multiply that times that $5 per hour per direct labor hour standard rate. The standard hours, make sure you look at the footnote down below. That, again, is one of those trouble spots for students when they're running these variances. The standard hours allowed given actual output is shown right down here at the bottom, this footnote right here. And the 21,000 standard hours equates to the standard of 0.1 direct labor hours per unit. And we had actual production and sales of 210,000 units. So we simply take the 0.1 times 210,000, and that's where our standard hours of 21,000 comes from. And that is right up here, right up above. So we take that 21,000 in standard hours and multiply it by the standard rate of $5, and that gives us $105,000. Then we take the difference between that and the $94,500, and that yields a favorable variable overhead efficiency variance of $10,500. And that's favorable strictly because our direct labor workforce worked less or fewer hours than we expected them to work. They worked 18,900 hours when in fact we had expected them to work 21,000 hours. So that's why we have a favorable variable overhead efficiency variance. So one last item here. What we've done then to wrap this up is we've compared the flexible budget, that's right here far right, the flexible budget, to the actual costs. And we have two variances. You'll notice that the flexible budget showed $105,000 in expected costs, and the actual costs for variable overhead totaled $100,000. So what we're doing here is we are explaining that $5,000 difference through these two different variances. This slide describes some of the possible causes for the variable overhead variances that you saw on the previous slide. And again, we would go out and research this. Being managerial accountants, we would try to figure out why we had these two different variances, assuming that they're significant enough variances to investigate. So I'll give you a couple of these. We'll start with the unfavorable variable overhead spending variance. And so why would our variable overhead spending variance be unfavorable? Why were those costs higher than we anticipated is really what we're getting at here. And one possibility is that we had a higher mix of indirect labor. We're not talking about direct labor here. We had a higher mix of skilled indirect labor workers, and that could increase our hourly rates above the expected rates, and that then would mean that our actual costs would be higher than expected. So that's one possible reason why that might happen. Then let's take a look, and you can look at the others here as well on your own, and let's take a look at the right here at the efficiency variance. Remember, we had a favorable variable overhead efficiency variance in that our workers were more efficient than we expected. So what might cause that? Now we are talking about direct labor workers because, remember, our variable overhead costs are allocated based on direct labor hours. So it can get a little confusing because over here we're talking about indirect labor. But here we're talking about direct labor again because that's how our costs are allocated. And because our direct labor workers worked fewer hours than expected, we had this favorable variance. So it could be that we had a higher mix of skilled direct labor workers than we initially anticipated, and that would cause those workers to be more efficient, right? If they're higher skilled than expected, they would be perhaps more efficient than expected, and that would lead to a favorable variable overhead efficiency variance. And again, take a look, there's some other possibilities here as well, and we would have to go out to confirm these things. This is just to give you an idea of what might cause these variances.